Let us discuss a topic on the remainder theorem. First, in general, we discuss about the numbers. If we can take any rational number, that is suppose 5 by 6 or 5 by 2 is there. Okay, it is an example. In this, the divisor is this. It is the divisor. The above is the dividend. Okay. How we are dividing this number means the dividend can be divided with the divisor. So 2 twos are 4, 1 is the remainder. Here, this is the quotient, the 2 is the quotient, this is the remainder. In general, the numbers. And verification of the division rule means we can take the dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. This is the rule of the divisor. Okay, this is the division rule. In this, the dividend and divisor both are numbers in general. In naturally, we are taking the division of the two numbers means, so we can take like this. Okay. But the rule is everywhere, whatever the numbers or polynomials, if anywhere, the division rule is division rule only. What is the division rule? Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay? The dividend means that is the numerator value, divisor is the denominator value. In this polynomial, we are taking two polynomials. One is the P of x and the G of x. These are the two polynomials. Here, the degree of the P of x is always greater than or equal to degree of the G of x. That is, P of x is greater than or equal to G of x. It's not P of x, it's a degree. We are concentrating on the degree. Degree of P of x is greater than or equal to degree of G of x as the number is like this. Numerator is greater than or equal to denominator, then we are getting the quotient, that is the number, natural number quotient. Here also, when we concentrate degree of the P of x is greater than or equal to degree of Q of x, when the P of x divided with the Q of x, G of x, then we get the quotient. After that, the last part is the remainder. This is the remainder. Okay. Same, if P of x and Q of x are the both the polynomials we are taking and it satisfies the condition of degree of P of x is greater than or equal to degree of G of x, then we can take the division of these two. We get the quotient polynomial and remainder polynomial. Then there exists the polynomial Q of x and R of x, such that it satisfies the dividend rule. What is the dividend rule? P of x is equal to G of x into Q of x plus R of x. Okay? Here, either R of x is equal to 0 or degree of R of x is less than degree of G of x. Just here also. Here we are taking either remainder is equal to 0 or the remainder value is less than the denominator value. Here 1 is less than 2. If this remainder is equal to that divisor, then the remainder is equal to 0. So when it is equal to, suppose here 6 is there, 6 by 2 is there. This is equal to 3. It is only quotient. Okay. In this, the remainder is 0. So, this 6 can be, dividend is equal to 3 into divisor plus remainder is 0. So, here the remainder part is 0. In some cases, the remainder is always satisfies the condition of the divisor, less than the divisor. Here also, whatever the number or the polynomial, if the degree of the polynomial is greater than or equal to degree of the G of x, when the P of x is divided with the G of x, then there exists the two polynomials, one is the quotient polynomial, another one is the remainder polynomial. These two polynomials with the given polynomial by the divisor rule or division rule, then the dividend is equal to, or the numerator is equal to quotient into denominator plus the remainder. The remainder value is always either equal to 0 or the degree of less than degree of g of x. Why? Because we are discussing in the polynomial about the degrees only. This is the one case. And here in your standard, just we are discussing the only linear polynomial. Any p of x is divided with the linear polynomial x minus a, then there exist two polynomials q of x and r of x, such that from this the division rule is the p of x is equal to x minus a into g of x plus r of x. Here where r of x is equal to 0 or the degree of r of x is less, either here r of x is equal to 0 or r of x is any constant value. Okay, here r of x is any constant value. Here whatever the linear polynomial x minus a is a divisor, the p of x is any polynomial, the polynomial is divided with the divisor when it satisfies from the remainder theorem. Means here if it is 0, it's clearly divisible, or if the part, if any constant is there, then r of a is equal to 0, then this r of a equal to 0 is the division remainder. Remainder theorem means this is the value of the remainder, r of a equal to value of the remainder. Okay, in this, from the definition way we are discussing here, in general if p of x and q of x are two polynomials, such that degree of p of x is greater than or equal to degree of g of x, and g of x should be not equal to 0, then we can find polynomials q of x and r of x such that p of x is equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x, where r of x is equal to 0 or degree of r of x is less than degree of g of x. Here q of x is the quotient and r of x is the remainder. This is the general division rule in the polynomials. In the remainder means, let p of x be any polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1, and let a be any real number if p of x is divided by the linear polynomial x minus a, then the remainder is p of a. Here p of x is divided with the x minus a is equal to, from this p of x is can be written as x minus a into g of x plus p of a. This p of a is, if p of a is equal to either 0, okay, here p of a equal to either 0 or p of a equal to not equal to 0. What is the p of a is not equal to 0, then that p of a is the remainder value of such polynomial. In the same way what I discussed here, this is the x minus a is the q of x, sorry, this is the g of x. X minus a is g of x, this is q of x, it is the r of x. The r of x means in the place of x is equal to, we are taking a, that r of a becomes the p of a, that is the remainder value. Just so you remember, the remainder theorem means when you are taking the p of x is any polynomial is dividing with the linear polynomial x minus a, what is the remainder? Remainder is p of a. You should remember this one. If p of x is divided by the linear polynomial x minus a, then the remainder is p of a. That is the remainder theorem condition. Okay. Now we are discussing some problems on remainder theorem. Let us discuss exercise 2.3. First problem is find the remainder when x cubed plus 3x squared plus 3x plus 1 is divided by, the first one is linear polynomial x plus 1, second one is x minus 1 by 2, third one is x, fourth one is x plus 5, fifth one is 5 plus 2x. Here, first we can write the, what is the remainder theorem? From the remainder theorem, what is that? Let P of x be any polynomial is divided by linear polynomial x minus a, then we get P of a is remainder. That is the remainder theorem. Okay, here just we can take what is the given polynomial, given that P of x equal to x cubed plus 3x squared plus 3x plus 1. What is the linear polynomial? Linear polynomial is x minus a equal to x plus 1, that is equal to x minus of minus 1. Okay? You are compared with the x minus a linear polynomial. Okay, here x minus a, that is, they have given x plus a. X plus a can be written as x minus of minus a, 1. X minus of minus 1. Here, what is the value? Here, a equal to minus 1. So, the remainder is P of minus 1, that is equal to minus 1 whole cube plus 3 into minus 1 whole square plus 3 into minus 1 plus 1. It is equal to minus 1 plus 3 minus 3 plus 1. Minus 3 plus 3 minus 1 plus 1 get cancelled. Here P of minus 1 equal to 0. Therefore, the remainder is 0. Is P of minus 1 equal to 0. This is the answer. Okay. Second problem. X minus 1 by 2. Second one. P of x equal to x cube plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1, x minus a equal to x minus 1 by 2. Here, a is equal to 1 by 2. So, the remainder is p of 1 by 2 equal to 1 by 2 whole cube plus 3 into 1 by 2 whole square plus 3 into 1 by 2 plus 1 is equal to 1 by 8 plus 3 into 1 by 4 plus 3 by 2 plus 1. Taking the LCM, 8 is the LCM. 8 plus 4 2 is 8, 2 4 is 8, 1 8 is 8. So here 1 plus 3 2 is 6 plus 4 3 is 12 plus 8 1 is 8. This is 8. 12 plus 8 20. 20 plus 6 26 plus 8 34 by 8. 2 4 is 2 17 is 17 by 4. This is the remainder. Here, remainder equal to 17 by 4. Third problem. What is the x? Here x. X can be written as x minus 0. This is equal to in the form of x minus a. That is nothing but a equal to 0. And p of x equal to x cubed plus 3x squared plus 3x plus 1. By the remainder theorem, remainder equal to p of a. Here, p of 0 equal to 0 cube plus 3 into 0 space plus 3 into 0 plus 1. It is equal to 1. Therefore, remainder is equal to 1. Fourth one, x plus 5. It can be written as x minus of minus 5. It is equal to x minus a. Here, a equal to minus 5, p of x equal to x cubed plus 3x squared plus 3x plus 1. By the remainder theorem, the remainder value is p of a. So here we are finding p of minus 5, that is equal to minus 5 whole cube plus 3 into minus 5 whole square plus 3 into minus 5 plus 1 is equal to minus pi cube plus 3 pi square minus 3 pi plus 1. Therefore, remainder equal to minus pi cube plus 3 pi square minus 3 pi plus 1. Fifth one, 5 plus 2x. It can be written as x plus 5 by 2. 2 into x plus 5 by 2. It is equal to 2 into x minus of minus 5 by 2. Okay, here this is equal to x minus a. It is something constant into x minus a. Here a is equal to minus 5 by 2. The remainder is p of x equal to x cubed plus 3x squared plus 3x plus 1. The remainder is p of minus 5 by 2 equal to minus 5 by 2 whole cube plus 3 into minus 5 by 2 whole square plus 3 into minus 5 by 2 plus 1. Simplify. 5 5 is 25, 25 5 is 125 minus 125 by 8 plus 25 3 is 75 by 4 minus 3 5 is 15 by 2 plus 1. Taking the LCM, 8 is the LCM, minus 125, it is multiplied with 2, 75 2 is 150. So 15 is multiplied with 4, 1 is multiplied with 8. 15 4 is minus 60 plus 8. It is equal to 25 plus 35 minus 35 minus 35 plus 8 minus 27 by 8. Okay, this is the remainder. Third exercise. Here, the second problem is find the remainder when x cube minus ax square plus 6x minus a is divided by x minus a. The third one is check whether 7 plus 3x is a factor of 3x square plus 7x. Is a factor means it is also indirectly we can find out the remainder value from the remainder theorem only. Why? Because when the remainder value is 0, then q of x and x minus a both are the factors of the given polynomial. If the remainder value is not equal to 0, then it cannot express as in the factor of x minus a and q minus x. So in this third problem, we can check out, is it remainder is equal to 0 or not? That is the case. But these two problems are based on the remainder theorem only. Okay. First, in this second one is second solution. By the remainder theorem, the remainder value is, the remainder is P of A. Here, given that P of x equal to, that is the polynomial is x cube minus ax square plus 6x minus a. And the linear polynomial x minus a. From the remainder theorem, the remainder value is P of a equal to a cube minus a into a square plus 6 into a minus a. That is equal to a cube minus a square into a is a cube plus 6 into a is 6a minus a. Minus a cube plus a cube will be 0. 6a minus a is equal to 5a. Therefore, here remainder equal to 5a. If the remainder is any non-zero value, then it is not a factor. It's x minus a is not a factor. The third solution, given linear polynomial seven plus 3x and p of x equal to 3x square plus 7x. Here, 7 plus 3x linear can be expressed in the form of 3x plus 7 can be written as 3 into x plus 7 by 3. It is equal to 3 into x minus of minus 7 by 3. It is in the form of some constant k into x minus a. K is a real value, here x minus a. What is a? A equal to minus 7 by 3. So by the remainder theorem, if remainder is equal to 0, then x minus a is a factor of P of x. Okay, here first find out the P of a, the remainder value. P of a equal to P of minus 7 by 3. That is equal to 3 into माइनस सेवन बाई थ्री होल स्क्वेयर प्लस सेवन इंटू माइनस सेवन बाई थ्री इज इक्वल टू थ्री इंटू सेवन सेवन जा 49 बाई थ्री, थ्री जा नाइन, माइनस सेवन सेवन जा 49 बाई थ्री, थ्री वन जा थ्री, थ्री जा हियर 49 बाई थ्री माइनस 49 बाई थ्री इट इज इक्वल टू जीरो. हियर क्लियरली रिमाइंडर इज इक्वल टू जीरो, रिमाइंडर इक्वल टू जीरो. देयरफॉर सेवन माइनस थ्री एक्स इज द फैक्टर ऑफ थ्री एक्स स्क्वेयर प्लस सेवन एक्स इज द सॉल्यूशन.